studio. Oh, that studio. Well, now, it has a story all its own. All those years, Charlie coming and going across the prairie, painting everywhere, makeshift studios, rooms above barns and the back of saloons. Our home in Great Falls was the first permanent place he ever had to paint. And it wasn't long after we moved in that the eternal fragrance of turpentine made it very clear that he needed a studio of his own. Charlie said if he ever had a studio of his own, he'd like it to be like the cabin that he lived in the first 2 years he moved to Montana. As soon as that studio was built, well, he moved everything that he owned in there, his collections, all of his materials, and all of the things that he needed to make his art. And I don't think he ever finished a picture that he didn't finish it there in the studio. And it became a place where his friends, where neighbors would gather. Well, I'd sit in the house on a summer's evening and listen to the low murmur of voices coming up out of that studio. And then every now and then, a wave of laughter would come up through the windows on a summer's evening. Our home and Charlie's studio tell the story of Charlie's life better than anyone or anything ever could. And who would have thought a girl coming from a farm in Kentucky would end up in Montana, meet a young cowboy artist who had immense talent, and that girl who knew nothing about art, let alone the business of selling it, would work side by side with that young artist as he became famous and wealthy. I won't be remembered except as Charlie's business manager. And even then, people will say I was too strict with him. Charlie Russell could have lived more than one lifetime and never gotten everything done. I asked him one time if he thought he'd ever run out of ideas for pictures, and he said a man couldn't live enough lifetimes to paint all the ideas that he had. And now that he's gone, I'd like to know that not only his art and stories remain, but that the greater story of who he was, where he lived, where he worked, that will be here for the future so that people can know a little bit more about the man, Charlie Russell. So that someday, some young artists can stand right there in his studio and imagine their dreams coming true.
I've been fortunate to be the only Mrs. Charles M. Russell and to have the opportunity to share Charlie's life. I'm honored to be part of his legacy, and I hope you will be too.